in this teachers training program on recent advances in application of machine learning and IoT in mechanical engineering, offering by a joint venture of AICTE and RGPP Bhopal and organized by Sagar Institute of Science and Technology, Gandhinagar, Bhopal. I am Nitin Kumar Sahu from Sagar Institute of Science and Technology, Bhopal. So before starting the session, I just want to give you a brief about today's sessions. Today we have a total 5 sessions. The first 2 sessions will be delivered by Dr. S. Danish Ashok. He is professor in VIT Vellore, and he will deliver 2 sessions. The topic of sessions will be first Fuzzy Logic for Intelligent Mechatronic System, and the second topic will be Neural Network for Intelligent Mechatronic System. Next 2 sessions will be delivered by Dr. Saurabh Pratap. He is assistant professor, IIT BHU, and his topic will be application of data analyst in e-commerce platform. So he will deliver the 2 sessions on this topic, and the last session will be delivered by Dr. Shruti Dhara Sharma. She is assistant professor, IIT Jodhpur, and her topic will be thin film nano composite temperature sensors and flexible sensors. So before starting our first session, I would like to read the profile of the speaker. Our first speaker is Dr. S. Danish Ashok. He is professor in VIT Vellore. He completed his Bachelor of Engineering in Mechanical Engineering from KLM College of Engineering and Technology, Madurai in 1998, then completed his master's degree from Thyagarajar College of Engineering, Madurai in 2003, then PhD in Mechanical Engineering from Indian Institute of Madras, Chennai in 2011. His area of expertise and research are artificial intelligence and machine learning, mechatronics, control systems, machine vision and image processing. He has published many papers in international journals and attended many conferences. His international journals include 48 international journals and 15 international conferences. He has 3 book chapters. He guided 12 doctors scholars, and he has 2 patented. He has many awards and recognitions. So few of them are Innovative Implementable Idea Award for Mobile Application Development for COVID-19 by Center for Development of Advanced Computing in SAMHAR COVID-19 Hackathon, which was held on 12th of May 2020. Fellowship and funding for developing a mine detection robot project under Teachers Associationship for Research Excellence Scheme from SERB during November 2018 to November 2021. Innovative and Leadership Award for contribution of development of first indigenous development of egg vending machine from Center Poetry Development Organization, Chandigarh, in on 12th of October 2013. And qualified in GATE 2005 with 88.54 percentile in production and industrial engineering. Achieved second rank in ME, that is master's degree in production engineering at Thyagarajar College of Engineering, Madurai. He has completed many projects and consultancy work. So few of them are development of novel deep learning visual surveying approach for mining detection using the mobile robot. The project cost was 18,30,000, and it was funded by DST New Delhi, and duration was 3 years. Development of machine vision approach for evaluating the spindle radial error of a machine tool. That project cost was 16,60,000, sponsored by DST New Delhi, and duration was 3 years. Development of motor control for a steering lock, development of wire extruder for 3D printing application, development of innovative techniques for cabin noise detection in HVAC system, and machine vision shorting technique and multi-extrusion mechanism for METI Manufacturing. So he has so many, he has done so many projects and so many consultancy works. So he has a very good academic and as well as a research profile. So with this profile, I would like to continue the session to our expert. Sir, kindly proceed the session, sir.
Yes. Thank you, Nitin sir, for providing me this opportunity and joining the session. A warm welcome to all the participants. And I am very happy to be part of this teacher training program. I hope this is the second day. You have a 1 week faculty development program on recent advances and applications of machine learning and IoT in mechanical engineering, organized by SysTech. So today's topic is fuzzy logic based intelligent mechatronic systems. And I am going to share some of my experiences of using the tools like fuzzy logic and neural network, which is very much part of artificial intelligence and machine learning. I have handled this.
Sorry to disturb you.
Yes.
Actually, your face is not properly visible. So is it possible you can just means change the direction of your sitting? Is it possible, sir?
Sitting, sir. Video, sir.
Yes, sir. Your face
means okay.
It is not visible because it looks dark, sir.
Sure. Okay.
One minute. I think proper light is not coming on your face. So, is it possible you can change your direction?
Sure. Is it fine, sir?
Yes, sir, fine. Now it is fine, sir.
Okay, thank you. Okay, so I hope this is fine and I'm ready to continue. So the topic of interest today is fuzzy logic based intelligent mechatronic systems. And this is the first part of the discussion today. And after this, I'm going to discuss about neural networks. So these two tools are widely used for developing machine learning applications. These tools have been used by industries to develop intelligent mechatronic systems. And I have handled this course for the past few years at VAT. So I'll be sharing my experiences of handling this course and how to build these mechatronic systems. So that's the focus today. So I would like to start with the context of this before getting directly into fuzzy logic. We know 2020 is gone and we are at 2021. What it going to give to us? So there are some technology trends. Let us address this and how we can use these technologies for building futuristic machines. So fuzzy logic and neural network is very much part of it. Let me address what is the recent technology trends. I hope this is the context today, and the topic is also very relevant to the teacher training program, IoT and Industry 4.0, and recently Industry 5.0. So we know that the industries are evolving very much. So the first evolution started in 1784. Where the mechanization started, and then slowly the mass production came in 1870, and then computer automation, cyber physical systems, and then currently we are at mass customization and cyber physical cognitive systems. So from this, what I'm trying to address here is you can see the years at which the industries are evolving. You can see 1784, 1870, 100 years. And again, next 100 years, there is another revolution. And now we are here in a stage where the systems are evolving. But you can see the years are reducing. You can see the pace at which the changes are happening. It's coming down. What it means here is the technology developments are at a higher pace. What happens here is the digital transformation of manufacturing systems. That's what we are moving on. So And the major aspect is there is a stronger collaboration between human and machine, which happens from the early stage to currently. The collaboration becomes predominant, and that's how the intelligent systems are coming into picture. So we need a proper collaboration between the machines to get better productivity. And currently the industries are in a disruptive stage. We know the context today, the COVID-19 is also affecting the industries. Apart from this, there are many technological interventions are happening, and this is a pie chart, or maybe the kind of distribution of technological interventions which are happening at different domains. You can see 5G, cloud computing, autonomous driving, smart factories, electric vehicles, AI and machine learning. So this is the focus today. So I'm going to address how we will be using fuzzy logic and neural network as a part of AI and machine learning, and advanced pervasive analytics, digital contents, and all these things are affecting the digital businesses. So what is happening in this year 2021? What it is going to offer here? There are many technological trends. The top technology trends here are artificial intelligence and engineering, edge computing, privacy computing, computations, 5G, intelligent business processors, internet of behaviors, robot process automation, hyper automation, human-centered digital experience, and digital workplace technologies, cyber security. So every industries are evolving in these directions at this point of time. So our focus is on this artificial intelligence, which is a buzzword today. You might have heard this term everywhere in the web sources, and it is covering up a large scope for various domains in computers, digital technologies, software, okay, robotics, optimization, knowledge, neural. So you can see many of these words which are coming in here. So I'm going to address the basics of fuzzy logic today. Okay. So we interchangeably use these terms artificial intelligence and machine learning. So intelligence is a part of human understanding, and learning is also the human understanding. So what it deals is developing algorithms which adaptively the systems can evolve and meet the requirements. So mainly this deals with data, and we use some training process for the machines, and we build the model, and it helps us to predict some outcomes. So that's how it learns, and it acquires these intelligences. So with this backdrop, I would like to get into the topic of discussion today. Right now we have covered the basis. Artificial intelligence is a technology which enables the machine to simulate the human behavior, and machine learning is again a subset of artificial intelligence, where the machine will automatically learn from the past data without programming explicitly. So the major aspect is how to make the intelligent systems, how to make intelligent systems like humans, so that it can solve the complex problems. So within that context, every industries are evolving, and they are trying to develop innovative components to solve the problems. So with this, I'll get into the presentation today. So I started with the context and background, and then I'll get into the definition of intelligent systems, followed by structure of fuzzy logic, how it can help to develop intelligent systems, and there are some mathematics behind that. And finally, I'll conclude this session, the first session, with the MATLAB demonstration. I hope MATLAB is a versatile software used by researchers, academicians, where we can also develop these algorithms, and we can simulate and develop intelligent systems. So this is the outline of the presentation. So the objective is to introduce the basic concepts of these two tools and mathematical structures. And I'm going to demonstrate that in MATLAB. So these three are the objectives. Okay, so with this, what is the definition for intelligent systems? So they are advanced machines. One simple example is the driverless car or the self-driving cars. So it can easily see and it can maneuver the road conditions and it can meet the requirements. It is an example for intelligent systems, and it is heartening to show this slide to you. You can see currently what we call this as engineering systems may not be intelligent at a particular time. You know the road conditions currently, and many people are losing their lives because of accidents, which happens due to oversteering and understeering during the cornering conditions, or maybe the external forces which are acting. What it mean here is we need to develop some intelligent systems to overcome these kind of problems. Though we have control over the systems, though the driver is having a control, but somehow these kind of deviations are happening. How to handle these kind of uncertain conditions, or how to tackle these problems? So we need to have some intelligence to avoid these issues. So this necessitates developing these intelligent systems, which has robust decision making capability. So the thing what it highlights here is, at a particular uncertain conditions, how to handle these systems, how the system can be handled better to avoid these kind of fatal accidents. So under these considerations, we need to look at intelligence is one of the options. So as a human behavior, we easily evolve and we will move away from the conditions which we prevail. But the systems or the engineering systems which we use should also have such a capability. Okay, so how to bring those intelligence in the system level? So that's the question. So from here on, I'm going to explain you some of the engineering systems and what kind of problems associated with those things. Then we can look at some of the techniques available to handle these things. So why this happens? Why this conditions happens or deviation happens? So if you look at that, every system we can see this as input output system. So a car can be considered as a multi input and multi output system. So what it mean here is there are certain inputs to the system and there are some outputs to the system. So we can constrain these inputs. You may have multiple inputs for the system. So I'm trying to highlight for the car, there should be vehicle dynamics, road disturbances, external forces, tire pressure. So these things, I am limiting this as my inputs. And what is the output is yaw rate, slip angle, aligning torque, lateral force. So these are all related to the car, how it is heading towards the particular conditions. These are all my output. So when these inputs are changing, the outputs are changing. Okay, but what is the connectivity between these two, whether we have a knowledge between these two or not? If we have a proper understanding on this, we will be able to avoid certain fatal accidents. So in one side you have some set of inputs, on the other side we have some set of outputs, but we may not know how these changes are happening and how to correlate these things. Okay, so this is a challenge for us. And there are certain other examples. As a mechanical engineer, we also look at machine tool systems. Again, here we have certain set of inputs and outputs, and you can see speed, feed, depth of cut, tool material, work material, and what is the size of the workpiece. This can be the input for the system, and some of the outputs are surface finish, tool wear, material removal rate, temperature, noise can be the output. But the condition here is, how can we relate these conditions, input to the output? Definitely the change which happens in the input side is going to affect our output. How can we control these outcomes? For example, I want a surface finish of 0.5 microns in a lathe or in a milling machine. Can I control that? it may not be possible because there are some input values which will be influencing this output, and that has to be monitored and controlled properly so that you can get the better outcome. So these are all some other examples. For example, electric motor, again there are some inputs and outputs. You can see current, voltage, pulse width modulation, flux, load. So when you change this output, like speed, torque, efficiency, heat, all these things will change. So one final example to address this complexities in engineering systems, again an automotive example, IC engines. You have throttle, fuel, load, air, ignition time, and output is again speed, torque, emissions. It's tough for us to model these inputs and outputs. We should have a proper mathematical understanding on this so that you can engineer your system. Okay, but the major aspect which I'm bringing out here is there are certain uncertain variations, unknown disturbances, system dynamics is unknown. You have only partial knowledge on this. Okay, this multiple inputs and multiple output systems is tough for us to handle. Because of that only these deviations are happening. There are many to many relationships are happening. You see in one side there are many variables and other side you have many variables. When these connectivities are complex, it's tough for us to handle. Okay, so as an engineer, we should not leave like that. We should control these systems. How do we control? So for that purpose, we have a mechatronic system or a robust control techniques can be used to control these unknown plants with unknown dynamics subject to unknown disturbances. Because in the realistic situation, a car moves on the road, we may not know what kind of disturbances the car may have. The bumps, the road conditions will vary. So every systems, engineering system has to handle these uncertainties which are prevailing in the input sides to the output sides. Then only it can survive to the particular conditions. But always we may have limited knowledge on this. Okay, so how to handle this when we look at more conservatively, how to handle this many to many relations? Always we try to develop some mathematical equations. We may build some regression models so that you will be able to connect the input variables to the output variables. We always come across these mathematics. We may use some maybe differential equations or dynamic equations to handle these systems. Okay, so to handle these systems, we build a mechatronic system which I could show as a flow diagram how the system or plant can be controlled. You can see this is the dynamic system which is evolving, and you need to have a system model for it. See, for example, this controller is the one which will maintain the outcome of the system. So for this purpose, what we have to do is this mechatronic systems will be helpful for developing these intelligent systems. The major aspect is the system model. So if you have the system model, it will be easy for us to capture those variations through sensors, and then the actuators will try to control these systems. So I would like to give a quote for moving ahead. We use these mathematics or the equations for controlling these systems, but these mathematical equations, when it refers to reality, they are not certain. And as far as they are certain, they do not refer to reality. This is quoted by Albert Einstein, and that is the basis for fuzzy logic. What it means here is the equations has a fixed setups, fixed number of model parameters, and it has assumptions. So it may not meet the realistic conditions which the systems are facing. So we need to go ahead with some new set of algorithms. So that we call this as soft computing systems. So under soft computing, you have various techniques. So under this, you have fuzzy logic and neural network. So fuzzy logic comes under approximate reasoning, and neural network is again a functional approximation. So we are going to study these two techniques today, fuzzy logic and neural network. These techniques, again, fuzzy logic is a tool which uses reasoning as the base to take better decisions. So let me give you the definition for fuzzy logic. So what we have covered here is the background about the engineering systems and complexities. The ordinary mathematical models cannot handle these uncertain things because of its own structure. So we are looking for some alternate tools here. So fuzzy logic is one kind of tool which is basically a mimicking model. So how brain functions, how the human inference and reasoning happens. So the same principle we are taking, and that is useful for taking decision making under uncertainty. So I would like to show some examples here. You can see the home appliances which are coming in. These are considered to be intelligent. You can see the fuzzy logic washing machines. So when we put the cloth here, according to the condition of the cloth and weight of the cloth, the water will be maintained, water level. And similarly, these smart TVs, so they will be able to control the brightness and the color according to the ambient conditions. Similarly, the camera, smart camera, can adjust the focus on its own, and it gives us better quality pictures. The air conditioners, so according to the room temperature and the number of people in, it automatically adjusts the airflow and the coolant level is controlled. So these are all some of the examples of intelligent systems, how to build a similar thing to avoid certain conditions. Okay, so this fuzzy logic is one of these techniques which is highly used for developing these intelligent systems. So let me address how we can use this fuzzy logic model. And it actually mimics the human brain. So human brain understands and reasons the vague data. One example I would like to show. So you can see this condition here. A person, there is a weight is going to fall on his head. So he is trying to tell a 1500 kilogram mass is approaching your head at 45.3 milliseconds, meter per second. See, to meet this condition, he can simply say, look out. These two are same. So that's the power of human brain. So human brain doesn't require a kind of precise information. Even with the vague information, we'll be able to take decisions. So this is the power of human brain. Using this power, fuzzy logic works. So the logic here is the entire aspect is covered in a single word itself. Okay, this through this word itself, we are able to capture the whole scenario. So that's what we'll be doing it in fuzzy logic. We'll try to cover it up through some set of words, and we'll be able to handle the particular situation. So let me show you the framework for fuzzy system. So you can see here, there are certain input variables which are changing here, and on the other side you have some set of output variables. So now the question is how to map this input and output, and that is done by fuzzy system using these modules. You have fuzzification, and then fuzzy rule base, and then defuzzification. So this, and downside you have some membership functions to address this uncertainty in the system. All together will map your input to the output. Okay, I'll be explaining these modules in the subsequent slides, and finally we will give you a demonstration in MATLAB how to map these input values to the output values. So what is happening in the first stage is we will convert this data into information, and this one is called intelligence, and third one is called conclusion. So what it highlights here is how we can take decision making. Is the decision making is done from the given data, and then we apply our intelligence, and based on the context and the conditions of the system, we will be able to conclude that this is what it is. So that's a human understanding, and human brain does some kind of analysis over that, and then it gives the conclusion. So the same thing, we are doing it in stages. Stage wise we are doing. First stage is analyzing the data and understanding the uncertainties, and then we apply our intelligence, and then we come to the conclusions. So this is the fuzzy logic system which is helpful for developing intelligence mechatronic systems. So I would like to get into some mathematics here. So how this happens inside the fuzzy logic. So here what we do is the input space or the input variables, speed, feed, depth of cut, or maybe material removal rate, surface finish, will be the output space. We will try to discretize this input space and discretize this output space, and we will try to map the conditions. And this mapping is done by some kind of rules. So I will explain what is this rules. Through rules we will be able to map these values. There will not be any equations. By means of rules we will tell that if this condition prevails, then this will be the output. That's how this connectivity is made in the fuzzy logic system. So Professor Lotfi Jada, so he is the person who developed this fuzzy logic system. He is a professor in Berkeley University, and he started developing this logic, and there are a lot of engineering applications came into picture to develop these intelligent systems. So the major aspect here is set theory. So I would like to explain what is this and how this is helpful here. So the under the prevailing conditions, for example, how the doctor diagnoses the fever. So many of us might have gone to hospitals, and how doctor diagnoses the fever. So he will check the symptoms like temperature, body pain, and cold. And according to the conditions, he will tell whether it is a general fever, typhoid, or malaria. Okay, how he addresses these conditions, how he maps this input to the output. See, for example, you have a low temperature and medium body pain and high cold. So whether this is a general fever, if everything is high temperature, high body pain, high cold, then it is going to be typhoid. So the conditions are changing here, and here also the prevailing conditions are changing at the output side. So doctor, what he does is he knows if if temperature is this and body temperature, body pain is this and cold is this, then he is able to connect. So this is a kind of a rule. It's a rule based system where the rules will decide the conditions and it will be connecting to the output. But what is this I'm highlighting here is the conditions are changing here. Low, medium, high, these are all the partial conditions. The partial conditions are highlighted by this low, medium, high. And according to the changes in the conditions, doctor is able to tell what kind of fever it is. So the same principle we are applying in the fuzzy logic system where we formulate rules here. And through rules, the inputs and outputs are connected. Okay. So this is nothing but simple connection between the characteristics. Like in one domain, you have some set of variables. In another domain, you have some other set of variables. But wherever the connectivity is made, you just make a mapping of these elements. And this is done by some set of rules. Okay. So what it means here is you have certain variables in input side and another variable in output side, and by means of these rules, if x is a then y is b, which is nothing but the relation. Okay, this rule is nothing but if x is a then y is b, if then rule. So if temperature is low, then this is a general fever. So this is the connectivity, or this is the rule based system where our human brain does. So we also use the same in the computational systems. Through the computations, we do the same kind of approach to make intelligent systems. So here, this if x is a then y is b, which we call this as implication. So if this then this, so this is called implication, and this is the rule or the logic which is described in the system, which maps the input side to the output side. Okay. So how to find, so this is the base behind the rule based system. So if you have any questions, you can ask me now. You have any questions on this? So shall we move on? Okay, let me continue. So what we are going to do is, now I have given you the background behind this fuzzy system and rule based system. So some mathematics are there, how to handle those input side to the output side under uncertainty. So one simple example I would like to bring. See, the thing is uncertainty, it means that whether Friday is a weekday or weekend day. You can see this question, whether Friday is a weekday or weekend day. Friday comes in between the weekday and weekend day, which is the partial condition. So fuzzy logic is nothing but it actually considers the uncertain situations. And we assign the partial values for those elements through some kind of sets, and we discretize the system, and then we'll be trying to map. Okay, so what I'm showing here is some of the examples of uncertain conditions. You can see this example again. You can see the variations which are happening here: disc, cylinder and rod. There are similarities around. Okay, there is a variation, but there are similarities. So you can see that these two looks to be similar, but the diameter has increased, height has come down, but all are evolving from the particular values. Like the values d by h, the value d by h defines these variations. So what we are trying to address here is, in the engineering systems, how the systems are changing, how the uncertainties evolved. So that is addressed by these variables d by h, and we will try to understand what is the overlap which is happening. See, for example, from disc to cylinder, from cylinder to rod, there is a kind of overlap. Okay, if that overlapping is decided by the value of d by h, still it is able to predict the variations. So the idea here is, what is the variation which is happening inside the system? So if we are able to capture those variations, we will be able to handle those changes much better. So we do some kind of analysis over these variations, and we formulate some kind of sets. So this is a set of discs, set of cylinder, and set of rods, and we group them, and then we try to keep them in a particular set, and we'll try to map it. Okay, so that's what this uncertainty is dealt here. Okay, and one more example I would like to bring here is to understand the uncertainty. We have some various mobile phones. Which is the best phone which we can procure? So if we want to pick it, it will be tough for us to select a particular mobile phone, because there will be an overlapping conditions of these characteristics will be connected to this mobile phone also, and something will be featuring here and it will be overlapping with other things, and that makes tough for us to predict and tough for us to select. Okay, that's a condition of uncertainty. So the point which I'm trying to address here is how to handle this uncertainty and how to model that, how to model these uncertain conditions so that we can make better decision making. So to address this, what we can do is, though we have a set of values which are varying, which are unordered, we can make kind of sets and we can group them based on the similarities, and that helps us better clarity. Okay, so this diagram will help you how to handle these fuzzy conditions, fuzzy and uncertain conditions. So whenever the data is changing, you have a mixed variations which are happening. If you are able to order it and if you are able to group it according to the characteristics, it helps us to take better decision making. So this is the idea where we can use set theory. So set is nothing but grouping of similar products. So we can group the parts based on similarity, and then we can tell at what conditions the systems are changing, and then we will be able to take better decisions. So that's the base for this fuzzy logic, where you order them in the first stage, you group them, and you limit it to a particular environment. So you have the parenthesis here, you limit it to the limit the values, and then you make a subsets for each elements, and then you will be able to map it to the outputs. Okay, so this approach is called fuzzy sets. So in fuzzy sets, you have each element and associated with the corresponding uncertainty. So when we talk about uncertainty, we may not know whether the element is belonging to the particular characteristics. It may be overlapping with other conditions also. So that is addressed by this membership value. So each element will be addressed by this membership value. and that is helpful for grouping the objects under uncertain conditions. So this is the fuzzy set which will be used for grouping the elements. We will be using these sets here. Okay, so fuzzy sets is nothing but, see, it's a multi-valued logic. So fuzzy logic is a multi-valued logic where you are able to map the values between 0 to 1. So 0 means you have a 0 and 1 gives clarity. So when you have values in between, they are called uncertain conditions. So you'll be able to map them between 0 to 1. Okay. So the second part here is the intelligence, or the how to connect these the variables. So the first part is to develop fuzzy sets, which we talked about now, through the membership values based on the uncertain conditions. Then the second thing is intelligence. So here what we will do is I'll give you a simple example. So when we go to restaurant, how we will give tips for the server? So if service is poor, then tip will be cheap. If service is good, then tip is average. If service is excellent, then tip is generous. So this is a rule. So through rule, you are able to map the input to the output. So here service is your input and tip is your output. So this is the rules. And you can see the service conditions, they are poor, good and excellent, and tip is cheap, average and generous. So these are all the fuzzy sets. The sets we make here, these are all the sets in the input side, and these are all the sets on the output side. Then the sets will be mapped by these rules. So this is called a fuzzy logic system. Okay, so in fuzzy logic system, what we will do is the input and output will be discretized by the sets, and the sets will be mapped by the rules. So here you can see this is input output and the rules, and input terms and output terms will be connected by these rules. So I would like to show right now the MATLAB demonstration of this, so that you can apply it for your own systems. Okay, so I would like to switch to MATLAB here. Okay, I think you will be using this MATLAB software for various applications. So this is the MATLAB interface. In the MATLAB, if you type fuzzy, you will be able to get a model here. Using this model, we will be able to generate this fuzzy logic system. So I think this is running in. Once it comes out, I'll switch to this fuzzy model and I'll explain you how we can use it here. So before that, I will continue further. So this fuzzy logic system, this rule-based system, gives us knowledge-based inference. So what we are doing is, this is a knowledge which we represent, and that knowledge only we are inferring it in the system level, and then we are taking decisions. So now I think the meaning of this fuzzy logic system will be much better. You might have read it. I think the model has come out. Okay. Okay. So this is the fuzzy logic interface. So this is your input and this is your output. So you can add the variables here. So if there are multiple inputs, you can have multiple input variables. and here you can have multiple output also. So let us have one small example for making rules and developing the fuzzy system. So I'm going to take speed, feed, depth of cut. So as all of us are mechanical engineers, so we know a machine tool system, how speed, feed and depth of cut will affect the output. Like output is surface finish and material removal rate. So there are two variables here, and speed feed alone we have taken, so I am going to add another variable as well. Okay, so while this comes, I'll show you how these variables can be mapped. Okay, so there are three variables: speed, feed, and depth of cut. So now you have three variables in the input side and two variables in the output side. You are supposed to map it. So we don't have any equations for connecting this. If I substitute speed, feed, depth of cut, I should get the value of surface finish and material removal rate. Okay. So we can do it by a rule-based system. So what we can do is we can make fuzzy sets. So this is the triangular function which indicates the variation in the speed. So speed, when you click it, you will be getting the x-axis how much speed. So I'll be giving 0 to 1000 RPM. So you can see 0 and 1000 RPM, and here I'll be assigning the terms like speed varies from low speed. And this is my medium speed, and this is my high speed. So when I change the speed, low, medium, high, you will be getting variation in the output. So you can see here low, medium, and high. And you should be able to change the conditions also. You can vary what condition you want, or otherwise you can keep it like this. So it actually maps the values from 0 to 1. So 0 means there is no value in that, 1 means you have a value, and 0.5 is uncertain conditions. So this describes the uncertain conditions, and this describes the changes which are happening. Okay, so similarly for feed, so coarse feed, fine feed, and high feed. So I am giving some different terminologies here, and again depth of cut, low depth of cut, medium depth of cut, and high depth of cut. So I'm discretizing this elements like this. Okay, and then you can make rules here. So you have rule structure. So if speed is low and the feed is coarse and depth is low, what is the surface finish conditions? So here also you have to make whether this is low feed, low surface finish. See, this low, medium, high is nothing but our understanding. Like human brain will understand what is low, what is medium, what is high. So fuzzy logic takes this low means the values will be ranging from 0 to 0.4 microns. So you assign these values, or if you want to make to 0 to 5 microns, you can make it 0 to 5. Okay. And then material removal rate, good material removal rate. Okay. Low material removal rate, high material removal rate. So three conditions we have given. Now we can formulate rules here. If speed is low, feed is coarse, depth of cut is low, then this will be, you can see the rule. So this is first rule, we are mapping from input side to the output side. Then if it is medium, the conditions will change here. This changes to medium. So you formulate another rule. If speed is high, surface finish will be very high. So you add the rule here. And if the feed is fine, surface finish will be low. So add it. And likewise, you can add many rules as per the conditions which are changing. So this is the artificial intelligence which you embed in the system. If these conditions are meeting, then accordingly you will be getting the output. Okay. So likewise, we can modify the conditions and you can add the rules. So now this is the demonstration for a fuzzy logic system. You can view the surface. So it will show you the surface profile, surface of the conditions. See, you can see here, I think this is evolving right now. This is a flat surface, but when you make many rules here, once you build the rules here, you will be able to see the changes in the surface according to the conditions which are changing. You will be able to you see the conditions. So this is the rule based system where the depth of cut and speed is changing accordingly, the surface finish will be mapped. Okay, so we don't have any equations to connect, but by means of rules we are able to map it. Okay, so I think we are at the end of this first presentation. So I'll continue at maybe at 11:10 the next presentation. Okay, so through this what I have covered is I think I have skipped a few things. I took some time for explaining the basics behind this uncertainty and handling the systems. The major point which I am trying to address here is this is a rule based system where the rules will decide your outcomes. So as a summary, I would like to show that this rules will be inferred at every stage and the actions will be taken. So this gives you the intelligent system where even though the system changes are happening in the input side, the actions will be controlling the system much better to deal the uncertain conditions.
Meeting.
For a presentation. Sir, can we start at 11:10, sir?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Short break for 10 minutes. We can start at 11:10. So thank you very much for your wonderful session. This was really a very interesting session. We have learned a lot, application of machine learning and artificial intelligence in the engineering and in the field of mechanical engineering. We have discussed about the fuzzy logic, its applications in the engineering, and we have also we have also understood the architecture of the fuzzy logics and how it works, how we can program it. We have you have also demonstrated a example on the MATLAB. So a very good thing which I liked about this session was the simplicity of explanation, sir. The way you explain the things, that was great, sir.
Thank you, sir. I tried my best, but somehow I took some time, but I think I will continue further on neural network also. I will continue further. 11:10, I think I can join.
Sure. Sir, there is a short break. You can take a 10-minute short break, then we start 11:10.
Yes. Okay. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir.
After the